What's going on, Fort Worth fam? It's the Kid Big Boss Table, Fort Worth fam, and I'm back with the video for you guys, man. Today I'm reacting to Elvis Presley live in 1956, man. Tupelo's Own, a complete six-track set, 13 minutes long. This is, I guess, some great, rare footage that I'm reacting to today, man. Supposedly someone had told me that today was Elvis's birthday. Was that what I was told? Correct me if I'm wrong. One second, let me double confirm. Someone had actually told me that today, yeah, it's Elvis's birthday. He'd be 86 today. Shout out to Ann Mills. So, yeah, man, this is a tribute to Elvis, obviously. Shout out to all my Elvis fans and supporters. You guys been rocking with me. Y'all always rock with me. Y'all show me love, man. And Elvis is a big part of this channel. So, rest in peace, Elvis. Let's get into this reaction, man.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and everybody else, the great moment that you've waited for. The one and only Elvis Presley.
He's already jigging, shimmying. Come on, cameraman, you gotta be more mobile. But I'm sure he's on some form of sticks or tripod there, but people are just hopping in his way. He can barely see anything. But so the six tracks are Heartbreak Hotel, Long Tall Sally, I Was the One, I Got a Woman, Don't Be Cruel and Hound Dog. Heartbreak Hotel, I Got a Woman, Don't Be Cruel and Hound Dog, I'm familiar with. I never heard Long Tall Sally or I Was the One, actually. But is this Heartbreak Hotel? The audio is slightly distorted, but yeah, buddy turned around like, oh, my bad. Man, you can just hear the shrieking from the crowd every 5 seconds. Dude just literally knew how to turn the crowd up. Literally, crowd engagement is very powerful as a star. But dude had that in the palm of his hand, in his back pocket. You know what I mean? But that's just crazy how he can just shimmy and shake just on the drop of a dime, just right on cue. And it's just like, you know, as a girl screaming, it's just like, as he busts moves, the crowd's emotion intensifies.
Sweet, you got
was at this show in 1956, put it in the comments right now, bro. I'm sure there's somebody out there who attended this show in Tupelo that's, you know, can able to relive this moment. But is Tupelo's own, and they're saying that in a sense, like, I think that's just, obviously he's from Tupelo, but what was this show called? I saw the beginning of it, it says something. But I was wondering if the actual, this actual show was called Tupelo's Own.
Everybody's tickled to death to have you home. Also, Elvis, we have with us Mississippi's first citizen who's also tickled to have you home, the Honorable J.P. Coleman, the governor, and he has a special word for you now. May we bring him out?
Yes, sir.
Governor Coleman, as the chief executive of this great Magnolia state of ours, your native state, I'm delighted that I was selected by the people of Lee County to present you with a document here, which we hope you will keep and treasure, which I shall now read to you because it'll take only half a minute.
Okay.
The state of Mississippi takes pride in welcoming home on the occasion of the Mississippi-Alabama Fair, America's number one entertainer in the field of popular music, its own native son, Elvis Presley. It's the 26th of September, 1956, J.P. Coleman, governor.
Boy said, in the field of popular music, boy, that's called a genre, buddy. Nah, but that's dope. It's like he got the key to the city, essentially. But, you know, going back to your hometown and getting commended, a lot of artists get that, like, they get the key to the city or, like, they'll get their own day in the city. So I think this was more so just showing respect to Tupelo's own, like, he's from where he's from, you know what I mean? But that's fire, man. And Buddy was young at this point to receive that much. And then because he obviously leveled up even further than this. A lot of artists aren't really getting that at this age, but obviously it goes to show how popular he was at that age, you know?
Congratulations. Thank you, Mr. Coleman. I hope you'll take this key and...
Was that not get off my stage,
that's where
man.
You see fit, sir.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, very much. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
I Was The One. I've never heard this record, man. Let me know what y'all know about that song, I Was The One. I haven't heard of that Elvis record. This is one of the two that I was missing out on. Okay, yeah. Fill me in on that one, man. I haven't reacted to this one yet, but if you're coming here just for Elvis content, check out my Elvis playlist. You can find a link to that in the description of this video. But I don't believe I have that one actually within my playlist, but go check out my videos in that playlist. If I do, let me know, man. Let me know.
Want you under a spell.
Oh, You know what blows my mind? I supposedly this track was uploaded from a gentleman in Germany, I believe, because he says regards from Germany within the description. Now, this piece of content was uploaded on Techno Haters channel, man, in March 5th of 2011. To say that, it's crazy how, like, people always talk about the fact that Elvis never went overseas, bro. Dude had all his stardom and star power, essentially, like, I mean, he was global, but he never traveled. He never, in terms of, like, outside the country to do shows. But that's crazy how many people he touched without even having to step foot out the States like that. You know what I mean? And do shows and performances and build his awareness and brand like that overseas and in the international space. You know, but it's people all over the world. He's a global icon, you know Elvis, you know, in foreign countries, third world countries, etc. And he's still that big, which blows my mind in a sense, right? Because back then, like a lot of discovery and media, I guess, a lot of stuff wasn't being covered. We didn't have as ease of coverage. You know what I'm saying? Like the media wasn't as developed back in those days. So the fact that people overseas knew who he was and has his name bubbled and stuff like that, that's kind of crazy. If you guys know how he kind of, you know, went viral like that, in the sense he's like going viral before the digital era even really existed like that, let me know in the comments what your whole perspective is and thoughts are on that. So I guess this is supposed to be I Got a Woman. He just performed I Was the One, right? Or is this, I may be lost, but I don't think this is I Got a Woman. Because I thought, maybe I was thinking about that James Brown song. That's the I Got a Woman. Is that even James Brown? I don't even know who that is. But I don't know why when I saw this within this actual track list that I figured that was Elvis' song. But I was way off. Elvis don't sing that song. But maybe it was his own rendition. Who knows?
Okay.
Wow, he invited a girl upstairs. Security's super late to get her up off stage. He's just now getting up there. She walked up, said, and just stood there. Oh my God. Like, ma'am, he's trying to perform right now. But that's crazy how much dance moves just get the crowd crazy, man. Girls, what? Girls love when a man knows how to shimmy and shake, man. Girls love a man that can dance. I don't know what it is about it, but girls be going crazy over that, man. Ma'am, come with us, please. I don't make cool. But I do. What does he say right there? I'm lost. I missed that. What does he say? Don't be cruel. Yeah.
Song, believe me, it goes something like this.
In this footage, Love Me Tender and Ready Teddy are missing, and only small parts of Hound Dog have been found in the Movie Tone archives. For this historical purpose and to make every bit of footage available for the fans to enjoy. Flexible to move like that, yeah. Movie Tone News. So that's Elvis Presley live in 1956, Tupelo's own, man. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Elvis, as usual, shutting it down, putting on a show, man. RP Elvis, happy birthday, Elvis. Definitely, got more Elvis content on the way. Like I always say, if you're trying to get familiar with more Elvis stuff I got, check out the description below and check out my Elvis playlist, man. With that being said, I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out.